internet issue is going on today, so it is very unstable, and that's why I was exited from the current meeting. Okay, now I was telling you about the another type of tank, another type of non-return wall. Here you can see the direction of water flow is same. Okay, now here you can see, here is the figure, spring, attached spring. Okay, and when water is flowing in this direction, at that time the pressure is being applied on this plate. Above that spring there is a plate, and hence the pressure is being applied on this plate, and hence it is dropping. That due to that pressure, it is allowing to enter the water through these openings, and water is moving in this direction. But when what the direction of flow will change, suppose you can see here, the direction of flow will change like this, at that time it will not be allowed to open, because due to the reverse pressure, this plate will get fixed into the notches provided over here, and hence the movement of flow of water will be closed. So this way it is running in a one way direction only, not the both way direction. So this is known as the non-return wall. Okay, so I hope you have seen this figure. Now we will see some other type of non-return wall. See here, this is also non-return wall. You can see there is a disc. Okay, here is the one disc, and it is attached at one end, and the movement of water is like this. Okay, when it is moving in this direction, this disc will go up and it will close. It will open the pipe and water will flow in a forward direction. But when the flow of water changes from this direction to this direction, at that time, if water flows this direction, at that time, instead of getting rise of this disc, it will be go back and it will close this portion. Entire portion will be get closed, and the movement of water in direction, this direction will be restricted. Let it be water, air, or any fluid, is it? So it will not be allowed to move in a reverse direction if there is a non-return wall is applied. Okay, so this is the function of non-return wall. Okay, now the next one is the air release wall. You can see at this figure. Check out this figure, please. Okay guys, I hope you have seen this figure. Now what is this air release wall? Do you know, many of the times when water is flowing through the pipe, at that time, because in the water there are the dissolved gases present. What type of dissolved gases are present? Oxygen, carbon dioxide, hydrogen sulfide, whatever the decomposition activities perform, or oxygen we are adding into that artificially, these gases are present into water, and hence sometimes when the longer distance is there, there will be a air trap, hawa pakad li jate, and if air trap is there, the movement of water will not be allowed to flow, the water will not be allowed to flow in a forward direction, and hence it will create a pressure at the back side of that particular air trap, and hence there is a chances to get the bursting of that pipe. So to take avoid that problem, we need to have some air release valve, and that air release valve will allow to release the air present into pipeline, and there will not be blockage of air, there will not be the air blockages, and there will not be the bursting of pipe will happen. So how it works, you can see here, this is in a closed position. When water is full, water is filled completely, at that time it will, that float will be floating upon the surface. This is a float, that round shape is the float. It will be keep on floating on the surface of water, whatever may be the level of water. And at that time, it will be, means if it is full, it will float and it will not allow to enter and go out the air. But when the level of water goes down, it will open the wall and simply it will allow to enter, release the air through this way. And if it is more than that getting open, that time the air may come back from this, okay? So this way, two way it can be functioned. Multiple times, this kinds of valve we are using in a syntax tank. Do you know? Otherwise, काय झालं असतं की आपण अंडरग्राउंड घरामध्ये अंडरग्राउंड टाकी बनलेली असते पाण्यासाठी, स्टोरेज करणं पाणी, वॉटर स्टोरेज साठी, बरोबर आहे. म्युन्सिपॅलिटीचं पाणी येतं आणि तिथं साठत राहतं. जर तो पाणी खूप वेळ आलं आणि ओव्हरफ्लो होऊन टँक सांडायला सुरुवात होते, बरोबर आहे. And that can be controlled by constructing using this type of wall. This is a float. It is simply closing the wall and opening the wall when there is less quantity of water. So two-way operation of air movements can be possible in a air release valve. In a air release valve. So whatever now I have discussed, it is displayed over here in this. You can see many problems can occur. Many problems can occur if air collects in a pipeline. Air might enter a pipe through pumps, packing glands, incorrectly installed joints, or it may even be present in the water itself. Once air enters the system, it tends to collect at high points in the line, forming air pockets that can slow flow or result in an airlock, stopping flow completely. A vacuum condition may be created as a pipe is being drained, okay, during no water condition, which could cause complete collapse, which could cause complete collapse of a pipe. Vacuum relief valves open to admit air into the system to protect the pipe as the water is being drained. Both air and vacuum relief valves are usually combined in one unit. These valves are generally installed at high points within a system where it is most likely to accumulate. Relief valves have a float or stopper which creates an opening for air to escape through. If the water level lowers, then after the air has escaped, the water level rises from a hill. So whatever we have discussed, that is what I mentioned over here. Okay, now, so until now, we have studied the different types of valves, and these are required. All these accessories are required for the smooth functioning of water distribution system. Okay, in the second section, in the first section of this subject, we have studied about the sources of water, what type of nature of water, how to collect the water, then how to treat the water, what kind of detailed treatment processes are required, that we have studied. In the second section, we are going to study about how we can make that treated water available to the public. And in that first thing, we have studied about the conveyance of water, how to convey. Okay, so as I told you, for smooth functioning of the particular pipeline, we need to have the control by various appurtenances, and among these, the pumps, pipelines, pipe material. Then next one, what we have studied, the different types of walls required for the proper performance of system. Okay, now we are going to study what are the different forces acting on the pressure pipes. Okay, there are the following different pressures may be acting upon the pipe when pipe is being used to flow the water. Okay, and what are these pressures? Why we need to take it into consideration the various pressures? Because the different pressures will decide the life of pipe, the life of pipeline, the life of distribution system. And that is very important. That's why we are going to study about the various forces acting upon the pipes. So what are these pressures? The first one is the internal water pressure. Second one is the external pressure due to overburden, temperature stresses, water hammer pressure, longitudinal stresses due to flow around bends, and then stresses due to foundation. Now I request to copy this slide. Then we will discuss each different pressure in detail. Okay? Please copy this slide. If you have copied, please let me know so I can proceed to the next.
Done, ma'am.
Okay, thank you. So the internal water pressure, what happens actually when water is flowing in a pipe? At that time, it creates the hoop tension in a pipe. The water is studding, and during the studding of water, at that time, there is a generation of gases also. Okay, generation of gases, and this creates the hoop tension inside the pipe, and that is acting upon the internal wall of the pipe. Okay, that is known as the internal water pressure. Actually, this internal water pressure, mathematically we can put in the form that F is equal to PD upon 2T, where P is nothing but the internal pressure of water acting upon the internal wall of the pipe. Then D is the diameter of the pipe, and T is the thickness of the pipe shell. Okay, so that way internal water pressure can be measured, which is creating inside the pipe. Okay, now the next one is the external pressure due to overburden. So when we are burying the pipe into the underground, at that time, what happens? When we are burying the pipe into the trenches that yesterday I have shown how we go for the pipelines. This may be the trenches. We need to go to excavate in a earth. And then in that trenches, you can put the pipes. Okay. So while putting the pipe at that time, we are covering, there is a bottom side, there is a soil. Also, we are covering that pipe from the surface side also. Okay. And for that purpose, we are using the soil. So what happens when we are burying the pipes, it takes, some pressure is acting upon that pipe on externally. And that externally, maybe from top side, maybe from bottom side. Okay, and that pressure will be different from place to place. How this pressure will be different from place to place? Because if that pipeline is constructed aside the road, that pressure will be different. And if it is crossing the road, at that time, that place, at that location, the pressure will be different. Okay, so it will change from location to location. And that can be determined by using the formula W is equal to C into gamma into beta B square, where, C into nu into B square. And nu is nothing but the unit weight of backfill material in kg per meter cube. What is that backfill material? When we are taking the trenches and putting the pipe, and to fill the gap between the trenches and the pipe, we are filling the material, soil material, most of the times, sometimes concrete, and it is acting the back, that backfill material is nothing but the, it is acting the pressure upon the pipe. So that mu is nothing but the unit weight of backfill material in kg per meter cube, and W is the load per meter length of pipe. It will be the load per meter length of pipe, and B is the width of trench. So whatever the trench we have taken, that width will be considered. Then C is the coefficient, which depends upon the type of soil and the ratio of depth to trench ratio. So C coefficient will change from place to place, type of, with type of soil, and it depends upon the depth of trench also, depth and width of the trench also. So this way, with the help of formula W is equal to C into nu into B square, we can determine the external pressure applying upon the pipe. All these factors we are understanding to understand the effect of to understand the life of the pipeline, whatever we have provided to the public for support supply. Okay. Now, what else type of pressure is acting upon the pipe? Is that is nothing but the temperature stress. Okay, in the temperature stress, you know, most of the time, this type of stresses are acting upon the pipe when the pipeline is laid above the ground and the pipe is metal pipe, because the solar radiations are hitting the pipe, and because of heating of the pipe, the temperature of pipe is varying, and due to that variation in temperature, the length of pipe gets changed. You know, if there is a temperature is increased, there will be the extension of pipe will be possible longitudinally. And in that case, if it is if this change is restricted due to fixidity or any other reason, the pipe will be subjected to following stresses. ज्यात आपण बघू शकतो की समजा दीज आर दी टू पीसेस ऑफ द पाइप्स, दिस इज द वन पाइप, ओके, अँड दिस इज द अनदर पाइप. सो दीज टू पाइप्स आर फिक्स्ड विथ द मटेरियल, सम जॉइंट्स ऍट दिस प्लेस. सो व्हाइल फिक्सिंग, व्हाट केअर वी आर टेकिंग? We are taking care that it should not be refixed, or it should not be getting means sutla nahi paije te. Okay, we are taking proper care that it is properly sealed, so water will not be getting lost. So that way, if it is getting connected, the fixed material is used to fix these two pipes. At that time, what happens? If there is an extension of pipe is performed due to change in temperature, at that time, it is restricted with this fixedity, and this will be, the pipe will be subjected to get the following type of stresses. What type of stresses are there? That is, Ft is equal to Ep into alpha into delta T. What is this Ft? Ft is the temperature stresses. Then Ep is the modulus of elasticity of pipe material. And then alpha is the coefficient of thermal expansion. And the delta T is the temperature variation. So this way we can determine what type of water stress or what is the water stress, temperature stress acting upon the pipe. Okay. Now we will see another type of pressure acting upon the pipe, and that is nothing but the water hammer pressure. Let me change the slide. Water hammer pressure. Simply, we know that water hammer effect is produced when velocity of pipe checked suddenly by sudden closure of wall. Suppose this is a pipe and this pipe is flowing full with the water in a particular direction, and when it is flowing full with a water in a particular direction and suddenly there is a check or there is a closing of function performs. This is a closing of a function performs here. I restricted, I closed the wall, whatever the particular wall is there, I closed. Then what happens? In a reverse, the way it was flowing in this direction, okay, now immediately it will start increasing the movement of water in this direction, and the pressure inside these pipeline at different location will keep on changing. Probably we can say keep on increasing upon the pipeline. So that is known as the water hammer pressure. Understood? Suddenly when we are closing the valve, when the water is flowing full in a water pipe, at that time it is giving a negative pressure, and that pressure is acting upon the pipe. Okay. So this is known as the water hammer pressure. Let us see with the slide. Water hammer effect is produced when the velocity of pipe checked suddenly by sudden closure of wall. When wall will be closed, there will be sudden rise in pressure. There will be sudden rise in pressure in a negative direction. Opposite direction, you can say. The maximum water hammer pressure, pH, is given by the following expression. pH is equal to W upon G into Up into V naught. Up is the velocity of pressure wave generated, then W is the unit weight of mass, and V naught is the normal velocity of flow in the pipeline before sudden pressure. Okay, so these are the different pressures acting upon the pipe. So just now we have discussed about the water pressure, water hammer pressure. Now the next type of stresses acting upon the pipe is at the bend. Is at the bend. You can see this figure. At the bend, when water is moving at through the bend, at that time, when it is moving from this direction to this direction.
Hello.
Ha madam.
Ha ma'am. B division madhe don mule ahet.
ओके यू कैन सी दिस फिगर. सो व्हेन देयर इज अ बेंच देयर विल बी अ प्रेशर एंड दैट प्रेशर इज नोन एज द स्ट्रेसेस एट बेम. When water flows through pipe beam, two types of forces acting upon pipe longitudinally, that is centrifugal force exerted by the moving water, and second one is the unbalanced internal pressure. Then what happens? This total pressure is being observed at this beam. And what is this total pressure? The total tension T in the pipe is T is equal to PA plus W into A into V2 upon G. So where internal water pressure P and A is the area of cross section of pipe, then W is the unit weight of water and V is the velocity of flow of water. Okay, so this way we can find out the different stresses acting upon the pipe. Understood? So there are the different pressures. Just we need to understand the life of pipe. Okay, so as a civil engineer, you need not go to in a detail, but you should know when you are studying a water supply engineering or wastewater engineering, you should know. So please, I request as this is some equations and all those, I request everybody to copy these slides. I think this slide you have copied. Now I request to go for this slide, please. Internal water pressure, and once you've done, drop the message so I can proceed to the next step, please. If you are done, shall I change the slide? Guys, if you are done, may I change the slide? हुआ कि नहीं? हेलो गाइस, देन व्हेन यू आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉप अ मैसेज एंड आस्क मी टू चेंज द स्लाइड, गो फॉर सेकेंड वन प्लीज. टू मिनट्स फॉर ईच स्लाइड इज सफिशिएंट गाइस. Over. Over. झालं का निकिता? निकिता भागवत, यू वेर अनम्युटेड.
यस मॅम, झालं.
Okay, I hope everybody has completed. Temperature stresses, please note down. Thank you. Four guys. So today this chapter may get end up, and we are going to learn very interesting chapter in the next. Over. Over, guys. Speak out at least. Yes, no, yes, no. Yet not finished?
Complete, ma'am.
Okay. And this is the water hammer pressure. Detailed information may not be required. Simply you can write down the equation and its explanation, how it can be used. Sometimes you may require, you should have in your notebook. ओवर. Done.
Complete, ma'am.
Okay. We'll proceed. Now, stresses at bends. Last one you finish and then we'll speed up little speed up, please.
Completed.
Okay, thank you. Okay, finished this task now. This one is not over, no? Up to this is over. Okay, by mistake this figure is placed here. It should be earlier as a stresses at bends. Now the new point we are going to study, and that is nothing but the economical diameter of pumping main. Economical diameter of pumping main in the sense you should find out the diameter of pipe which will give the better performance with a better cost. Means optimal pipe, optimalism you should do in respect of efficiency and in respect of untrusted cover. Trust anyway. Optimalism we need to go for. So we'll, I can show you the figure also. If the diameter of pumping main is decreased, thereby increasing the velocity of flow for a given fixed discharge. Suppose discharge is fixed and we are